Okay, I'm back. I'm bringing out the big dog. My emulsion blender may have turned my back for too long, though. Let's see. Chunks on there. Oh, okay, that's garlic. But yeah, what the hell. All right. Okay, that's mixed good. Now it's boiling. Got it nice and mixed. Got lots of bubbles in there though. That's all right. They'll calm down. Yeah, they're calming down already. Let's push them to the side. It'll be fine. It's not thickening though. Let's get it to a boil first. Get it to a rapid boil first. Then we'll turn it down and let it see how it thickens. It's almost there. Okay, that's start the boil away. Once you can't stir it away, it's there. All right, everything's incorporated nicely. Okay, I think that's close enough. I'm wondering if it's time to put it in the meat. I think so. That looks good. Let me give it a taste. I have not tasted it yet. Nice and thick. It doesn't leave a line thick, but it's pretty good. Not sure I like the taste of it though. Ding ding. Dinner is served. Nope, never mind. And if I try and get it to do it, it won't do it. It only does it when I'm not trying. This stove is weird. I'll get it. These days I'll get used to it. Won't be long. Won't be long now. I think we're good to incorporate this in with the meat. I don't know. I don't know if I'm gonna like this very much. Feel gritty. What am I doing wrong? Tastes gritty. Here's the cream cheese. Does it go well? I don't know. I think once we incorporate it into the meat and bake it, it'll be fine. But yeah, it's tasting a little gritty. Oh boy. We're just gonna put it in here. Uh-oh, you okay? Did I hit you? I dripped. I don't know what I'm doing. There. Alright. We're gonna cook this a little bit now. Oh boy, I'm getting backed up on cleaning, aren't I? And the onions, the garlic into the meat, and the sauce into the meat, and hopefully thicken this up a little bit before we put it in the oven, because I'm pretty sure it was thicker than this, and I have a pound of burger in here, and I just put extra cheese in there. I said 2 cups. Better fucking cook down. So I think, yeah, we're just gonna bring it up to a nice simmering boil and then reduce it and let it simmer for a while. I would probably like the taste if it was creamier, but it's not. And all I put was cream, cheese, cream, right? Sour cream, half and half cream. And it's pretty. It'll be fine. It'll work out. Get it hot here. Get it boiling.
Well, pot boiling. Oil and trouble.
Yeah, this needs to thicken up a lot, or I have to strain it out. Just fucking put some fucking pre-made cheese. I don't know. Because I can strain all this out, that's fine. And then put that other cheese in there and it'll be fine. Nice and creamy cheese, but what the fuck? I tried to make it? No. That is not how you do it. Should have just made the roux and cooked the flour out. I'm trying. I know it doesn't look very good right now. I hope I didn't waste a pound of hamburger. It's not boiling. It should be boiling to the point where I can't stir the boil away. Yeah, it's on medium high. There it goes. I mean, I don't want to turn it like a cake-like substance, but good lord, it was supposed to thicken, right? Turn it down and simmer this sucker for a while. See if it thickens up. So I just boiled it for like 2 minutes. I'm gonna turn the oven off right now because I keep thinking it's 4 o'clock. The oven on 400. It's the only time it takes the time away. So I don't know if you're seeing this as I stir it. See how it falls off the side of the pan? Like that? That's weird. I'm not used to seeing that. You know, maybe the people that put this out as a recipe should know what the fuck they're doing before they do it, because this doesn't look right. God, it doesn't look right at all. I'm just going to have to keep simmering it. But I can't just stand here and stir it for another 45 minutes, right? All right. And I want it to thicken so I won't be putting the lid on. I just want the steam to evaporate all the moisture out and thicken that shit. It's still boiling a little bit. I'm gonna wait for it to stop boiling before I walk away from it. I don't want it to burn. Have it on low. Very low, the lowest before it clicks off. It is thickening up, though, I have to admit. It is thickening up. But I want it way more thicker, right? Isn't that what you want? I should have just put cheese in there. Cheese. I could just make some macaroni and put it in here. Call it goulash. Creamy goulash. I'm not sure I have enough tater tots to cover it. What if I don't have enough tater tots? What if they just sink in all this sauce? I think that's way too much sauce for a pound of hammer. And she said, 2 cups of milk with a half a pound of hamburger. I'm like, what the f- this is 2 cups of milk in a pound of hamburger, and it's still not. It's way not thickening up. I'm going to complain about that recipe. No, I'm not. I don't care. I ain't no fucking caring. I just do it and move on. Move on down the road. Moving on. Okay, I think it's good to sit and simmer here like this, just steam and let some of the moisture out. Yeah, I think it's fine, just like that. I think it'll stay steaming. I don't know. I'll keep my eye on it. I'll set the timer for 10 minutes. 7 minutes. Okay, so I'm back. I've got most of the dishes done, and this is ready to go into the pan and into the oven. So I put all the meat and everything in there, so it did thicken up quite nicely. Put a little more cheese in there. Yeah. And so we're going to dump this into the pan. That's the way we're supposed to do it, I think. I'm thinking. And I got most of the dishes done, so I'm very happy about that. And we don't do corn here, so there's no corn in this. That could be the key element, but we do not do corn. We are doing green beans separately, so a side dish. Green beans and salad as a side. Okay, so now the moment of truth. Moment of truth. Am I going to have enough tater tots to cover this? I don't know, but it looks good. All right. Yeah, it tastes good too. I think we're gonna have plenty. There's a lot in here. I think we're gonna need a bunch in here. These are Ore-Ida golden tater tots. And they're frozen. It's almost the whole bag. I don't know. Oh. A little bit of ice in there. It'll be all right, I think. Am I supposed to de-thaw these first? Maybe, huh? I don't know. I don't want a bunch of excess water in there, right? You know, I'm just gonna layer them in there. This is weird. Okay, I might have to defrost these. So it's cold water, you need to do a rapid defrost on that. And I'm gonna put, I think I'm gonna, the water, the oven will evaporate all that water, I'm sure. I'm sure. That is nice. I just want the excess ice off of it. And then they'll be fine. They're frozen for sure. I'm a doofus, what can I say? I am definitely a doofus. Doofus, doofus, doofus. I'm not sure I'm gonna have enough. Maybe, huh? I don't know. It's weird. It's just weird. Going that way. That's what I should have done. Made a design. Yeah, I'll have enough. Definitely have enough. What do I do with the rest of them? Put them on a cookie sheet? I don't know. Toss them, put them back in the freezer. What do I do with them? I can't put them back in the freezer because I've already started the defrost process. I might be able to squeeze them all in though. Maybe so. It certainly doesn't make those perfect lines like they show. This one still has ice on it. I'll put a different one there. That one still has ice on it. I'll have ice left on. I'm gonna use most of them, absolutely, but I do have enough, which is awesome. I'm just gonna try and squeeze another row in that little corner. Left. Five, six. I push up. Maybe I need to push them down a little bit, huh? Roll them over. If I can fit another row. Boy, casserole. Who just thought I'd ever be making this? Never, ever thought. All right.
Okay, I think I can fit one more in that corner. And that will leave 7. So, all right. I'm going to go ahead and just toss the rest of them. There's not very many. There's only a couple. Okay. This is ready to go in the oven. And the oven is ready. So. How long do I cook it for? 20 minutes, maybe? How long would I cook the potato tots for? I want to know how you're going to get the underside cooked. Ooh, something's in there. There's something in there for sure. Definitely something in there. Okay. The pull tab to the half and half. Okay. I got all the dust from the towel. I switched the white one with this one. That one was all wet. Alright. Uncovered. Let's start with 20 minutes and see how it goes. Alright, 20 minutes on the clock. Here we go. Move, please. I don't want you to get burned. There we are. Maybe a little further back. All right. Okay, well, so thanks for joining me in this video, and I appreciate you coming to my channel and checking me out. And if you like what you see, go ahead and subscribe. And if you do that, then maybe you could help me out and share this video out so more people see it. And that would be wonderful as well. So, our cowboy casserole, I'm sorry, it cracks me up, is in the oven. And I'm just going to do some cleanup, and then I'm going to probably dig into this pineapple and get this cut up and put into the fridge. Can't eat it until I open it. So, and I got a messy stovetop. Messy, messy stovetop. So, I hope this works out, and I would definitely show you the end product, of course, and that will be a separate video. You can only pause your phone for so long, and then it just shuts it off, so. Uh-oh, I'm just making a mess all over the place. Just making that mess. Oh, boy. Really bad. It's really bad. This stove streaks so badly, especially when the oven's on. You just can't wash it when the oven's on because it dries too fast. Get rid of the streaks. So,
Uh-oh, I missed a spot.
Yeah, like when the oven's on, there's just no way. Like you have to wait for it to cool down to get the streaks off. I don't know how to clean the stove properly. I just, you know, I'm using glass cleaner, but I can't do it when it's hot. So what do you do until, right? You don't want to sit there with a dirty stove, a streaky stove, while you're waiting for it to cool down to put glass cleaner on it. The only thing I can think of is light reflection. Which means you go over, instead of doing a straight where you can see it, in circles. Like that. And then you can't see it as much because the light refracts. The circle refracts the light. So the light makes it look like it's good. I don't know if you're seeing this, but. Okay, that's a little too wet of a spot. Dry spot.